In this video, I am going to show you how to communicate Delta PLC with TouchWinHA. Okay. For example, I have taken these parameters which are present in Delta PLC. Okay. First one is bit monitor. So I am going to monitor these bits in PLC. Second, I am going to control the output. So these bits I am going to control through HMI. And third one is timer monitor. Here I am going to monitor the timer register value. This TD1 means it is a T1 timer data register. So I am going to monitor this TD1. And fourth one is counter monitor. So here I am going to monitor CD2. This is the data register of counter 2. Fifth one is data register control and monitor D2. So here I am going to control and monitor these data registers D1 and D2. And sixth one is data register monitor. Here I am going to monitor data register D3. So now we'll make one program in Delta PLC. Okay, I have made already program. This is my program. Here I have used Delta PLC SA2 series. Okay, now I will explain this program. If X0 is high, I am making M0 coil on. If M1 is high, then I will run the T1 timer. Timer value I am giving through this D1 data register. So whatever value I am entering in D1 register, according to that, this timer will run. Next, M2. If M2 is high, then this counter will count. Next, 1 second pulse input. So here I am incrementing the data register D3. So every 1 second, the data register D3 value will be incremented by 1. So next we will do the program in HMI. For that I have to open the software, create new project, select Delta DVP series PLC. Okay, parameters are there. So there are no need to change these parameters. These are the default parameters. No need to change. So here baud rate is 9600, data length is 7, parity is even, and stop bit is 1. Okay. Next, project name. Okay, new project is created. So far we will do the program in HMI. So first we have to monitor these bits, right? So for that I'll make program. So for monitoring I'm going to use lamp. So first one is X0. So I'll select X0 here, and second one is Y0. So I'll select Y0. And third one is M0. Okay, already M0 is there. No need to change. And fourth one is T1. And fifth one is C2. T1 means timer 1, C2 means counter 2. If T1 timer is on, then we will get the indication. If counter C2 is on, then we will get this indication. Okay. So we will name this lamps. First one is X0. Second one is Y0. M0, T1, then C2. So these are the bit monitors. So I will give name bit monitor. Okay, next one is control the output. So I'm going to use button here. So first output is Y0. So I'll select Y0 here. Second one is M1 and third one is M2. So I'll use reverse operation here. M1. Next one is M2. So here M2 is pulse type. So here I'll make it as moment type. For moment type, we have to select on instant. So here also we'll name the outputs. First one is Y0. Second one M0 is the input for timer. This will enable the timer and the PLC. Third one is M2. This M2 is used for counting. So name is control output. We'll make output control. Okay. Third one is timer monitor. So which timer we have to monitor? T1. Then we have to monitor data register value of T1 timer. So TD1 we have to monitor. So we have to select digital display. So we have to select TD1. And here it is a 100 millisecond timer, so I'm making on float value. So total digit is 5, in that one digit is float value, so I will get 100 millisecond timer here. Okay, next one is counter monitor. So here we have to monitor data register value of counter 2. So for that we have to select CD2. So here we no need this float value. So here we have to select CD2. So timer monitor and counter monitor, this one will name here. Okay, next data register control and monitor. So we have to control and monitor the data registers D1 and D2. For that we have to select digital input. So value we have to monitor and control is D1 and D2. So D1 is used for timing value. So this is the 100 millisecond timer. So here also we have to select floating value. Okay, fonts, same font we will select here. And the second one is D2. Here there is no float value, I'll make it to 0. Okay, and last one is data register monitor. So for that I have to select digital display. We have to monitor D3 value. Font I'll select same font. Okay, program is correct. Now we will download this program to the HMI. Similarly, we will download this PLC program to PLC. So now I will connect PLC and HMI cable to PC. First, I will download the PLC program to PLC. Okay, PLC program is downloaded. Next, we will download the HMI program to HMI. Now we have to connect PLC to HMI. So this is the PLC cable configuration. So this is the connection. We have to make the cable like this. This is the pin number 235 and 548. Okay. So this is for RS-232 connection. So we have two options to connect this PLC to HMI. So we have to use RS-232 protocol, or we have to use RS-485 protocol. So both protocol we can use. So but recommended setting is RS-232 protocol. If you want, you can use RS-485 also. So these are the default settings. So we have to use same settings here. So if you use RS-485 means we have to connect the cable like this. These are the pins 4 and 7. 4 to 1 we have to connect, and 7 to 2 we have to connect the wires. Okay. So these are the device addresses in PLC. So I made the cable using this pin diagram. HMI said DB9 female connector. In PLC said 8 pin mini DIN connector. So we have to connect it to PLC port. We have two ports, PLC port and download port. We have to connect it to PLC port. So this is the PLC and HMI connection. Now we will check our program. So first we have to check this bit monitor. So we have to monitor x0, y0, m0, t1 and c2. So first we will monitor x0. So I have connected one push button to x0 here. So I will press this push button. So x0 is on now. Here x0 is connected to m0. So if I make x0 on, m0 also will get on. So that logic is working here. So I am making x0 on. So we are getting indication for x0 and m0. Okay. Next one we need to get y0 indication. For that I will make this y0 to on. So we have button here. So I will press that button now. So now y0 is on. So y0 indication is working now. So m0 already we have seen. Next we have to test t1 and c2. That we will check afterwards. After that we have to control m1. So this m1 is connected to timer. If I make m1 to on, this timer will run. Before that I need to set this timer value and counter value. For timer value I have to set the value in d1 register. For counter value I have to set the value in D2. So here I did not mention the name. So I will mention the name here. Then only we can easily understand. Again, I will download this program to HMI. Okay, now we will check. Now we will check from first. Okay, first x0. Okay, working. M0 also coming. Okay, next one is y0. I am making y0 on. Okay, it's working indication. Next we have to give timer value to these data registers D1 and D2. So timer I'll use 20 seconds and counter I'll use 10. Okay, then I have to make M1 to on, then this timer will run. So I'm going to make M1 on. So now timer is working here. If the time value is reaches to 20, then we will get this T1 output here. So now 14 seconds. Okay, 20 seconds is finished. Now we got the T1 output. So similarly we will check the counter. For counter we have to give the input in M2. So M2 I have assigned here. So we have to press this M2 to make the counter up. So now I'll press M2 to increase the count value. Okay, now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have set counter value is 10. If the counter value is equal to 10, then we will get this indication, C2 indication. So now I will make it 10. Okay, now this counter value is equal to 10. C2 bit become high. So timer monitor also working and counter monitor also working. And next one is data register control and monitor. So we can able to enter the data register value here. We can change this data register value. Next one is data register monitor. So D3, we have to monitor D3, so it's monitoring every 1 second the value is incrementing. So all the parameters are working in HMI. So communicating to Delta PLC with this HMI is very easy. There is no difficulties in communicating Delta PLC with this TouchWin HMI. First we have to select the PLC model. That's it. After that we have to make the cable as per the pin diagram. Then we need to do the program in PLC and HMI. And we are downloading program to PLC and HMI. So it is very easy to communicate Delta PLC with TouchWin HMI. Okay. So this is about the Delta PLC and TouchWin HMI communication.